then road, then transportation, then congestion, then vehicle collisions, then possibility of moving in narrow lanes, then tackling, overtaking, all of these things are quite known to people. They cannot write it in order. The software has written it in order. Some idiot, they should have taken some sort of Herculean strength or arduous risk in writing all of these things. So there is a driving software for which whatever you have to do with your eyes and attention, your hands and eyes operation in steering and road maintenance or road vigilance, and your hands and legs, eyes and legs. So this is what they have made. Whatever I am saying, very simply, they have told it in euphemistic and technical languages. This is not a development at all. Now the recent development is the brain computer. The brain computer interface. Brain computer interface, you mean that very simple. There are three things. Among the five senses, three senses are knowledge oriented or communication oriented. Audio, visual and speech. The taste and smell, they are not connected with any information or communication technology. They can be communicated, but they cannot communicate. So that is this thing. So that which is communicable, that which communicates, are two types of indriyas or sense organs, in which the three things are there meant for recognition. That is audio, visual, speech recognition. Now what they are willing to now make, the recent project, you know that? In latest bioinformatics, they have created an artificial man. Now they are planning to create an artificial man, that is the communication system of a man, now they are planning to get. So, in cognition technology, there is cognitive aid. What is cognitive aid? It is supplying tools in which you can have better performance. Cognitive replacement, that is replacement of tools where you just operate, you need not perform something more. It does everything and you are just an operator. Then cognitive rehabilitation. That is a very great thing now. What is it? Cognitive rehabilitation. Whenever there is a cognitive impair, it may be a wild impair or a mild impair. Wherever there is an impair, this cognitive replacement that rehabilitates a person, for example, audio replacement, video replacement, they are based on McGurk's theory or McGurk's model, in which they have understood if the picture is changed, for example, if you change a picture, immediately the auditory response, it also changes. If the auditory response is different, then the optical response, it also changes. It is used in disabled children, those who are mentally retarded, those who are tetraplegic, those who are having no mobility at all, and also people who are, that is, impaired. Now they are now rejecting that they should not be called as impaired people. Now before that,
special ability.
Yes, special ability. At first they are handicapped people, then physically challenged people, then impaired people. Now they are specially gifted people or people with a special ability or talents. Now to develop some sort of compensation for the lost ability, as soon as we boost the available ability, there are two things. To compensate the loss, for example, if there is visual loss, then how to create a vision balance of memory, vision projection, dream projection, conversion of audio into a possible methodology of a visualization inside. All of these things are being dealt in handicapped people, mentally retarded people, disabled people, and people who are, those who are having slow processing. Mandamatis, those we used to call in Sanskrit, lot of people are there. See, handicapped persons, they need not be physical. There are a lot of intellectually handicapped people, those who are having linguophobia, those who cannot master languages. Then arithmophobia, those who are against mathematics, chemophobia, physiophobia and biophobia with physics, chemistry, and neurophobia with brain structure. So innumerable things are there. So intellectually handicapped people, they form 81% of the student community. 81% of the people, they are intellectually disabled. So this type of intellectual disabling status, now what the Western world says is, you have to keep a guidance software. And you have to get the benefit. There are three problems. When this software will be fully formed? Now it is just for driving. And can we be driving throughout our life without doing any other work? Number one. Number two, if we are doing, that is known as multi-sensory application, multi-sensory perception, multi-dimensional execution. That is the greatness of human brain. Multi-sensory perception, multi-dimensional cognition, multi-executive ability. These things are the greatest of human brain. For each and everything, if you develop a software, then if you conglomerate a great or grandfather software, Somebody can become grandfather. So like a grandfather software, if you can bring that, then it is going to happen, number one. Number two, what will be the affordability? If one software for driving is 50 lakhs, then instead of which we can get to driving, or we can refrain from the driving itself, we can walk better. The third thing is very important, impact analysis. If there is a software, you see already a small mobile with less complex or dynamic action. Mobile does not have lot of complex or lot of dynamic actions. It is just a communication agency. Even using the mail, even using computer, even using a mobile, on normal things, lot of things are predicted that they must be very, that is restricted to use, or they should not be used, or handled with care. Handled with care has not been written in these things, but they are advising. So if there is a chip that is going to come, or if there is any such software which is going to come, what is the impact of its nature on inherent intelligence of human brain? How it will genetically affect, how it will be physiologically affecting. Certainly it will affect the three major areas. One is the circulatory system, heart, and second is the cognitive system, the central nervous system. Third is the mind and its balance. Certainly we swear, without any understanding, closing our eyes, we can say that such any development of any cognitive additional skill which is developed from a mechanical aid or mechanical source, either it may be an external source or aid, it may be an implantation, transplantation, or a prosthetic connector, whatever it may be, it is going to create that problem. So our greatness is how to create the same thing by means of man, either with the assistance of another capable human being, or to develop the same capability within ourselves, and to derive the capability from the present environmental compulsions or contextual emergence. How we can create that? That is the major thing. So coming to the concluding session, that how there can be a system of convergence in which they can get the benefit. What do they call by convergence? Convergence means like synergy. What they call is nanotechnology, information technology, biotechnology, and cognitive technology. All of these things, they must totally contribute for the development of a system or a cluster of systems. That is known as convergence. The synergy is what they call. It is a great convergence, and it is going to be the dawn of the future order of science. There is a very great research work done by Dr. William Sims Bainbird, he is called. He has done a research on this convergence. First, there are four orders. Number one is innovative development. What is the use of this convergence for innovative development? Number two, what is the use of this convergence for understanding of life, that is the cell system or the basic life system? What is the usage of these things in understanding the fundamentals of principles or ontology? How this thing can be used? Fourth thing, how it can be used for enhancing science and technology or the cognition and communication technologies now? Number one, how innovative talent is developed? What is the use of these technologies? Number one, nanotechnology, unless the nanoscale or the microscale or the molecular status of objects or particles are understood, we cannot understand the realistic behavior. There are three types of behaviors. One is a basic behavior, and the second is a secondary behavior. Third is a tertiary behavior. Basic behavior that exists at the time of its inherence. Second behavior that comes at the time of growth. Third behavior comes at the time of response. So nano level, I have already delivered a lecture on nanoscience. I told that how nanoparticles, they behave differently.